chin down a little bit.
Every picture tells a story.
And whatever you do, don't smile.
Every time Steve Rapport snaps a shot.
Yeah, that's quite gangster.
Photographing New Orleans guitar player Joshua Starkman, Steve is still a rock star. Just like in London in the 80s, focusing on the biggest names in the music business.
Freddie Mercury.
Took this photo at Wembley Arena in London on September the 5th, 1984. In this picture, I like to think that Freddie is going, Mama!
David Bowie.
So when I got to the studio, I saw David walking towards me. He extended his hand, grabbed mine, said, Hello, I'm David. You must be Steve.
Paul McCartney. Looks like he's singing.
Mother Mary comes to me. Yeah, he's singing Let It Be.
Of course, Tina Turner.
Well, this is very poignant. It's happy and sad right now because Tina came to the studio in London in 1985. And then there's just this arrival of hair and clothes and Tina and presents. And she was wonderful. She stayed really, really late. She was so apologetic. She was so accommodating. She danced for us.
Then he quit, called himself a recovering photographer, until a trip to New Orleans in 2022 and a photo shoot at Preservation Hall. He sold his house in California and 10 weeks later flew back to his forever home here.
New Orleans got you back behind the camera.
Came out here last year, fell in love with it. The magic, the beauty, the vibe, the streets, the culture, the history, and of course the jazz music. Mick Jones of The Clash, the last time he ever played with The Clash in London.
He opened a French Quarter shop he calls the Mostly Rock and Roll Gallery.
Bono at the U2 house in Dublin.
With so many stars still to shine.
Here's Gary Clark Jr. at Jazz Fest.
Steve Rapport will soon need a space as big as the New Orleans night.
Turn more towards me.
Bill Wood, WGNO News.